Neil Marston joins us now from Bryah Resources for more updates. Neil, great to get you back in.
Good morning, Danny.
So there's a lot of news for us to pick through from the time since we last spoke. Let's start with the news released just this morning, shall we? You've identified some manganese in rock chips at two new areas of your Bryah Basin project. Tell us all.
The latest results we've put out relate to our Bryah Basin project. That covers about 700 odd square kilometres of ground in the Bryah Basin, which is home to the De Gruyter copper gold mine, which is the richest copper mine in Australia. So we've been looking at the manganese, as I mentioned in our previous interview a few weeks ago, and the two new locations we've had some samples come in on in the last day or so are at a place called Black Caviar and another area which we've called Devil's Hill. And we've been getting results of up to 49% manganese in rock chip samples, which is very encouraging. And in the Devil's Hill area, we've identified manganese outcropping over an area of about 600 metres long, which makes it the largest area we've seen to date, which hasn't been drill tested and hasn't had any mining on it. We're very encouraged by those results, and we're looking forward to getting out there and doing some drilling in the next few months on that ground.
Can you tell us about the consequence of this manganese find at the Bryah Basin? We do understand that you recently attended the Manganese Institute conference in KL. So what is the outlook there? What is the potential boon for investors?
Since joining the Institute, as you mentioned, we've attended the conference last month at Kuala Lumpur. And that gave us a great opportunity to talk to basically all the players in the market. So you've got a forum where buyers, sellers and traders all get together and update the market and everyone on aspects of the manganese trade. And certainly the outlook and the atmosphere at that conference was very upbeat. And the outlook overall for manganese going forward is very positive from all accounts. So as far as we're concerned, it's a good time, an excellent time to be looking at developing our manganese assets. And we've certainly been advancing the work we're doing on the former Horseshoe South mine, which we've acquired an option over. And with all the sampling work we're doing at the moment, we're actually finding there's more manganese around the more we look. So we're very encouraged with the early work we've done, and we're planning to drill a few of these areas in the coming weeks.
Well, that's very positive news for the Bryah Basin with the manganese, but of course, a lot of high-grade copper and gold also at Bryah. We do understand that you've recently completed a whole raft of surveys and are looking to start drilling at the Jupiter and Mars prospects. What can you tell us about this aspect of operations?
The groundwork we've just completed is been some moving loop survey work, and that's been a follow-up to a helicopter-borne VTEM survey we flew in February. And the VTEM survey came up with a number of targets, and three of those were what we considered high priority targets based on the preliminary data we had at the time. We've commenced or undertook the ground EM survey on those three targets, and each of those targets has been confirmed by the ground surveys. And the results were sufficiently encouraging for us to then evaluate some other opportunities whilst the crew was in the area. So we tested another area which turned up the final data we've received on the VTEM survey has shown up some other anomalies. And so we've done one of those in the Peak Hill area, which is again confirmed by ground work. And two areas up in the Mars prospect, which are coincident with Pathfinder metals for VMS type deposits. So we thought whilst we had the crew in the area, we'd survey them, and that survey was done over the weekend, and both of those have come up positive as well. So there's a little bit of modelling work going on in the next few days, but by next week we should have the conductors properly modelled up and the final location for drilling holes to be laid out on the ground.
So that's great news on Black Caviar, Devil's Hill, Jupiter and Mars. But remind us, in the wider project area of your flagship Bryah Basin works, what is the overarching strategy for this project? What is the overall status update?
The focus obviously is on getting that drilling program underway on the copper and gold. And so at Jupiter and Mars, where we've had those conductors tested, We've got the ground clearances and program of works approval from the state government to go and do that work now. So we'll be out in the ground in the next 2 to 3 weeks with a drilling rig and drilling that activity. And fortunately, we've been able to receive a grant from the state government, which is what they call a co-funding program. So we've got 24 holes planned, of which the government's going to share half the cost up to $150,000. So we've got these high priority targets, which we're going to be drilling in the next few weeks. And then in the broader sense, we've got the manganese strategy rolling along in the background. The aim is to try and monetize those assets from low cost mining operations as quickly as possible, given the current market. But, you know, overall, the Bryah Basin is renowned for its high-grade copper and gold, and we think at the Jupiter and Mars prospects, we've got some very exciting targets which are lining up through the geophysics, the geology and the geochemistry. So now it's time for us to put the drill rig on the ground and see what we can find. There's been some shallow drilling in some of those areas, which has been encouraging, but it was never drilled deep enough. So we'll be drilling some holes down to 250 plus metres to test these targets.
So Neil, that's a very thorough update on the Bryah Basin, but of course, Bryah Resources also has a project at Gabanintha.
The Gabanintha project, we did some drilling last year at a place called Tumblegum South, which we intend to go back and do some follow-up work in the next few months. At this stage, we're probably talking about drilling by about September, and that'll be a short program to extend some of the holes we drilled previously and also do a number of extra holes. And there's a number of other areas where we see some opportunities for us to go and explore based on some previous work that's been done. So we'll probably broaden that program to a couple of other sites as well. So that's just ticking along in the background, but certainly there's some opportunities there to find some high-grade gold from the previous results we've received.
So Neil, finally, can you remind us, please, moving forwards, what are the next key milestones for Bryah Resources that we need to keep our eyes peeled for?
Over the next few weeks, Danny, we'll be drilling up on the ground, testing the copper and gold. And that will obviously be the catalyst for major news flow over the coming months. We've got at least 6,000 metres of drilling planned, so that will take well over 40 days to undertake that program on a number of target areas. So investors need to keep us on their watch list over the next few months as we get this program completed. We're looking forward to having some positive results and hopefully creating the next new discovery in the area.
Well, Neil, sounds like busy times at Bryah, which means that we hope to get you back into the studio very shortly to keep us updated.
Look forward to it, Danny. Thank you.